Daryl, is this realistic?
Well, it is for some people. But if you have a criminal behavior problem and you continue to use drugs and you continue to rob and you continue to steal, now you're putting other people in danger.
I'm not arguing that. I was arrested for burglary first. Then I was arrested on a possession charge after and violated my probation. So I'm not arguing that if you drive and you're drunk and you get a DUI, should you go to jail? Yes, because it is against the law to drive drunk. However, testing dirty, she didn't come to probation and get caught.
But I gave you that privilege. I gave you the opportunity to prove to me that you were gonna abide by a condition because legally I could have just put you in jail.
If we could order every addict just to stay sober, then we would have cured addiction.
When someone is on probation, are they given enough resources in most circumstances? Because I do understand the perspective of, if you're a judge and you say, you know what, just stay off drugs. Yet if you're addicted, realistically, if you're not having the appropriate resources, you're probably not going to stay
and
off
we don't
drugs.
And we don't have enough money for the resources.
So that is
breaking probation is a whole new issue. It's
so,
a whole
so breaking
new
probation
offense, but,
is really but, possible. And it is something that probably happens on a very regular basis because of a lack of access. That is the problem. Should we be punishing people that have a lack of access of good quality care when they have a disease?
Most addicts and alcoholics have to become responsible because, see, everybody just let them have their way, you know, and everybody enable them, and they continue to do the same thing, and nothing changes on the inside for them.
Yeah.
It's an inside job. It's not what we look like on the outside. Everybody wants to say, well, you know, I have this problem, but if I never deal with my core issues of who I am and what's hurting me, I can never get well. I mean, I could have kept using excuses for myself. It wasn't until I started dealing with my inside. It wasn't until my wife said, you need to take off that baseball uniform. You're not a baseball player anymore. Mm. You need to learn to become a man.
And it's interesting to me how Daryl said going to jail stopped the bleeding. Alexis, for you, it was almost the opposite. It was your ability to rehabilitate on your own, and maybe.
Well, I don't even credit it just to myself. I mean, you talked about responsibility. When this man found me and I was several days into a heroin detox, on my second offense, I was 19 years old. This man came to me and I was in the throes of it. And the first question he asked was, are you ready to take responsibility for your life? I had no idea what that entailed. And I was scared, but he said, you're going to go throw yourself at the mercy of the judge and you're going to tell him that you need treatment. Now, I'm one of the lucky few that was, I didn't have insurance, right? I didn't have access to treatment except for the fact that I was a D-list celebrity and somebody wanted to offer me a free year of treatment. Many Americans don't have that.
True. She's right about that. Where's the funds? And the funds have to come from the government. You know, we got to stop trying to be political correct, and we got to start dealing with the brokenness that's in America with young people with addiction.
And it's true. And look, I don't think there are any easy answers here, and I actually do believe a lot of it, getting back to you, Mary, comes down to the judge understanding. What I love about you is you understand addiction.
But that's a big problem.
And a lot
you have a variety of judges. You know, judges who are old school that think, oh, throw them into jail. Yeah. You have judges that say, all right, let's try this. Then you've got judges who just get involved and say, I want to be part of your life. I want to help you. But you got to help yourself first.
Sure.
So just like your attorney, God bless him, you know, are you ready to turn it around? Mm-hmm. I mean, that's where you're at.
Yeah, it's always, you got to understand in this field of dealing with addiction, it's always people helping people.
Yeah.
And you got to let people help you. That's the real key. We never turn our back on someone that has a drug problem or alcohol problem. And their life matters. I've seen young girls in my treatment center, 19, 20 years old, that's already OD two and three times. And I sit down, have a conversation with them, and they open up and tell me the pain. The uncle molests me. Mm-hmm. Somebody's raped me. See, they have we have to get back to where the psychiatrists have to be able to deal with these people and help these people and not push them to the side. Don't just give them a pill to make them feel
better.
Well,
the common thread I'm hearing here from all of you, and I think you'll agree, is obviously, at some point, an addict needs to take responsibility, but also needs to have someone to help them along the way. And it sounds like all of your stories have that common thread. Look, there are no easy answers. That's why this entire season, we're covering this in our series, The United States of Addiction. I thank you all so much for your input on this. Daryl actually has a new book out. It's called Don't Give Up on Me, available now, discussing a lot of these important topics.